Southern and Grambling Bayou Classic down in New Orleans. First half action. Jags setting the tone. Block punt. Elijah Allen recovers it in the end zone. Just like that. 7-0. Southern with an early lead. Grambling with an answer. Jeremy Hickbottom buying time. Looking downfield and finding Daryl Clark in the end zone. That tied the game at 7. Moving ahead, second quarter, more from the Jags. Ladarius Skelton going deep to Trey Smith. He is inbounds for the touchdown. Southern with a 17-7 lead. It was 17-10 at the half. Now second half. Jags in the red zone, but Allen Clark recovering a fumble. He takes it all the way down the field, eventually taken down inside the 20-yard line. Tigers settle for a field goal on the drive. Fast forward. 31-13, Jags. Hickbottom shortening the deficit, calling his own number for the touchdown. Two-point conversion good. We had a 10-point ball game, but that's as close as it got. The Jags, too much in this one. They topped the Tigers 38-28, the final. NBC 6's Jory Perrys was there and has more. Jory?
Well, the Grambling State Tigers season coming to an end in the 45th Bayou Classic, a game where Grambling fought hard but was never able to fully claw all the way back. An 18-point deficit being shortened to 3 in that second half, but the narrative of turnovers in this game began right away. Southern's first touchdown coming off of that blocked punt, and Grambling never able to capture any lead throughout this game. And although the loss hurts, the team says that they are proud of the effort through four quarters.
Well, I'm so proud of my kids. You know, you're not going to always execute. You're not going to always play well. You know, you strive to. But, you know, to see their heart, you know, fighting back, you know, getting themselves back in the ball game, that's the thing that I enjoy the most. And it shows that they get it. You know, a lot of teams would have given up when we were down 31-13. But these guys fought back, and they are champions the way that they – you know, continue to fight tonight.
If it ain't 4-0 on the clock, we still pushing. If it ain't 4-0, we still pushing. That's the whole mentality of the whole locker room.
We went down with 31-13. It was like 5 minutes left in the third quarter. We knew we had the rest of that time and the whole 15 other minutes. We just like, when the fourth quarter hit, we just, who gonna quit? Who gonna quit or who gonna keep playing?
So the 67,871 people here in attendance today definitely saw another entertaining game in a classic rivalry. For now, though, reporting here at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome, I'm Jory Perrys. I'll send it back to you in the studio.